This is one bottom string support. This is the base plate. This base plate can be welded over the structure or can be bolted over the structure through four bolt holes. And this is bottom supported string. That means pipe shoe will rest over this load flange. This is called load flange. At sight, we can adjust this height. Suppose this height is 250 millimeter, and at sight, gap between structure top and pipe shoe bottom is 270 mm. If we rotate this load flange, height adjustment provision is there. Around 40 to 50 millimeter height adjustment provision is there. Now it is raising up. Okay. It is raising up. And it is coming down. So at sight, we can adjust height of this string support. This is called load flange. Over this load flange, pipe shoe, that means pipe is placed over this load flange. And these two are lock nuts on both the sides. Against this plate, the string is compressed. Now, this is actually cold preset load, 133 kg. And this is hot load, 129 kg. And vertical movement is 4.4. That means now string is compressed at 133 kg. And after 4.4 millimeter movement, that means 133 minus 4.4 into string constant, this 129 kg will come. So, in operating condition, string will be loosened by 4.4 millimeter, and at that condition load will be 129 kg. So at operating condition, when pipe will move up by 4.4 millimeter, then this string will provide 129 kg load. If the pipe comes down, then the load will be 133 plus string rate into the amount it comes down. Now at site, after installation of the string support, these nut and lock nuts should be loosened. If the string movement is 10 millimeter up or down, then these below two nuts will be loosened by more than vertical movement, and above two nuts, these nut will also be loosened. This nut will also be loosened. Then we should wear this type of SS wear here like this. And another wear like this. Otherwise, due to vibration, this nut will again go up, and this nut, now suppose this nut is here, has been loosened and spring is taking load, this nut due to vibration may come down here. So after raising this nut, we also mount this wire below the nut so that there will be gap and spring can move up and move down. If we do not hold the nuts by SS wire, then due to pipeline vibration, upper nut may come down and lower nut may go up. Then spring plate will not be able to move up and down, and there will not be any spring action. Then spring support will act as a rigid resting support. Now, these below two nuts, these two nuts are load adjustment nuts. These two nuts will always remain tight. But if we want to change the string load, suppose this string load is cold load 133 kg. But say we have done a mistake and we want string load as
153 kg. So we have to increase the cold preset load. In that case, this nut and this nut will be opened first, then these bottom two nuts will be tightened so that spring will be tightened by that amount with spring rate, so that this load will be 153. Suppose spring rate is 5 kg per millimeter. If we want to have cold load as 153, that means we have to increase cold load by 20 kg. So if spring rate is 5 kg per millimeter, then it will have to be raised by 4 millimeter. So in that case, we lose this nut by 4 millimeter and tight this nut 4 millimeter, this side also by 4 millimeter and 4 millimeter, so that spring will be compressed by 4 millimeter. In that case, this cold preset load will be changed to 153, and at that condition, hot load or operating load will be cold preset load minus vertical movement into spring rate for upward movement, and for downward movement it will be cold preset load plus downward movement into spring rate. Now this is bottom spring support. So pipe bottom is supported over this load flange, and this is spring hanger. This is actually hangs from any structure, and pipe clamp or pipe is hanging from this. So in this condition also, whenever this is, that means pipe comes down, then operating load increases. When pipe goes up, then operating load decreases. But functionally, these and these are same. After installation, we have to open these two nuts and these two nuts, and these two will be kept tight for load adjustment. These two nuts will be opened and loads will be adjusted.